So, the reason I'm up here instead of Schmitty is because of this gordito.
Hola.
I don't speak the Spanish because I come from South Dakota, and up here we speak French. Peer. Chamberlain.
Versailles.
I first met this young man, and we played a lot of beautiful music together. And then he moved and started hanging out with all these weird desert folk who speak Spanish like they're strange. They probably actually don't even speak Spanish. They just all pretend. Chile.
Buenas noches.
Gabacho. Anybody know that word, gabacho? It's great.
Tell him it means something. It means a lot to him.
Without further ado, I just want to introduce to you, who haven't seen him yesterday, one of my dearest best friends and all of his friends who I can't wait to be friends with. This is Jackson's flatboat.
Thank you, Johnny. It's really good to see you again. Look forward to picking with you around the fire tonight.
To the town of our freehold rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him when he went along his way. Hickin', hickin', hickin' out long back of life. Then said it didn't matter, he was at Texas Man. Town of Iowa Free, who rode a stranger one fine day.
Let's start that one.
Hardly spoke to folks around him, and it went along his way. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. Came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came a whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
By the name of Texas Ran. And many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 94.
1 in 94.
Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona Ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. He was after Texas Red. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew the handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. When they stopped to make their play, and the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas red had not cleared leather for a bullet fairly ripped, and the ranger's aim was deadly with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made a fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with a big iron on his hip. A big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
Thank you. Sorry, Johnny left me a little speechless there, so got a little tongue-tied. Hope you don't mind. So this is a super special place for me, and most of you guys here, we've boogied together before, and I meet a lot of new friends every year, and a lot of old friends, and people in between that I re-meet a few times, but it's really thank you so much for your warm welcome ever since I've been here and making me always want to come back. South Dakota Friends of Traditional Music is quite a special organization. And I think all you guys are honorary Friends of Traditional Music. Thanks for being here.
And let's just give a big round of applause while we're at it to all the volunteers and the crew that made this happen this weekend. We've been to a lot of festivals, and they're at the top of the game. There's no doubt about it.
So I just want to talk a tiny bit more. Introduce this song here. This is an old folk song that I've loved for a long time and played as a bluegrass number and stuff. But it was here. I was here sitting next to my friend Andy. It was the first time I'd been at this festival. Andy Shaw. We were like right there, and Charlie Parr was playing. And I think we'd opened for him, or friends opened for him a couple times, got to know him a little bit, but just got blown away sitting that close to Charlie Parr. And he played this song in a really lonesome, Andy didn't judge me for crying a little bit.
And we do it nothing like Charlie Parr.
But contrary to what Keith says, that's been a major inspiration of how I like to play this now. So credit where it's due.
And it's on our EP.
This goes out to Charlie. He's probably playing somewhere else tonight.
My age. to be controlled. So I drew a pistol from my side. Of the woman that he loved, said, "Honey, now you're left alone."
Anyone notice this fiddlest over here? Legendary Tom Schaefer. We're so proud of ourselves that he was willing to play with us. Such a humble guy, and he contributes his talents and his wisdom. You know, just being there and playing tunes with him, we learn a lot from him. And he makes other people proud to be around him. And we're really happy to be in his presence. Not like he really cares himself that way at all, but such a good dude. And learning this tune that I wrote, I feel very honored. Thank you. I know it's not the easiest one either. So we have an EP, and it's called The June Rise. It's a single, a handful of singles from an album due out. It's called The June Rise, and this, I guess, is the title track. That's bueno. Listo?
A little less of me in the monitor.
Oh, you're in that monitor, all right. The devil's in that monitor, too. Let's exorcise the demon out of this monitor with this song, okay, guys?
born, he'll grow up fast. Lazy mule, kick your ass. Wild, cold, fast, it runs. Twinkle in your eye, tear in some. Wait till the June rise come.
Could I get some monitor, that other guitar down and monitor? I think here, definitely. Great.
All right, we're gonna do some shuffling here on stage. I don't mean fiddle shuffling. Well, some of that still too. Callie Autry here, multi-instrumentalist. She really beautifies our sound so much. Thank you, Callie.
Thank you.
And she's playing this thing here. It's called a melodica. Check it out, people. It's like a little keyboard that you blow air into. Similar to another instrument, like an accordion or something. He left his guitar out in the rain.
Is anybody from Nebraska here? Yay! I'm from Nebraska, too, and my family, we traveled up to South Dakota a lot when I was younger. But this is my first time at the festival, and I am having a great time.
Nebraska needs to represent itself better out here, so y'all take that home and tell folks that.
Well, you could
practically still a little bit of the other guitar down in the monitor here. Thank you. That's more better.
Are we ready, boys and girls?
All right.
I'm asking them, are you guys ready? All right. All right, I guess we'll play another song. Left out on the street into field. There's the bass. Foolish choices are starting to pile up down by the healer. It's a hungry 100 miles from Silver City and a lonely, lonely trip through the healer. My job at the saloon, the piano out of tune, and the sheriff's little brother, bullets through. Left on in Appaloosa, now I'm leading a burro. I'm just drunk and I'm sad. My sins are catching up. And I can't outrun these thoughts, 'cause a donkey won't gallop down by the healer. It's a hungry 100 miles in Silver City. Left my job at the saloon, the piano at a tomb, and the sheriff's little brother, bullets through. drunk and I'm sad. My sins are catching up.
Thank you, guys. Every time we play a set, we like to play a prank on Alex here and mute one of his instruments.
It's a fun game for me. I love it.
He figured it out a little quicker this time, actually. So yeah. That trick we might have to find a new trick here pretty soon. Say adios to Tom Schaefer. Thank you so much for playing the fiddle.
Yeah, Tom.
Ow! He just came out of the woods, and that's where he's going back to. I don't know. He's a fiddle troll.
He's been doing that for 39 years.
Yeah. I think I found his lair, actually, but I don't want to go in there. There's a bunch of squirrel bones out in front of it. Okay. Well, this is a song about Cali. It's called Mexicali Blues.
Laid back in an old saloon with a peso in my hand, watching flies and children on the street. And I catch a glimpse of black-eyed girls that giggle when I smile. Little boy that wants to shine my feet. Said he's right from Bakersfield. I don't know why I came. I guess I came to keep from paying dues. So instead I grab a bottle and a girl that's just 18 and a damn good case of the Mexicali blues. Yeah. Is there anything a man don't stand to lose? Devil wants to take it all away. Cherish well your thoughts, keep a tight grip on your booze, 'cause thinking and drinking are all I have today. She was fresh in town. I didn't know the state line ran from hell. She had raven hair, a ruffled dress, and a necklace made of gold. All the French perfume you care to smell. She took me up into her room, whispered in my ear, "Go on, my friend, do anything you choose. I'm paying now for those happy hours I spent there in her arms. Lifetime worth of the Mexicali blues, yeah. Is there anything a man don't stand to lose? When the devil wants to take it all away, cherish well your thoughts, keep a tight grip on your booze, 'cause thinking and drinking are all I have today. Thank you. man rolled into town, some thought he was along. Billie Jean was waiting when he came. She said that he would take her if I didn't use my gun. I'd have no one but myself to blame. I went out to those dusky streets, blood was on my mind. I guess that stranger hadn't heard the news. And killed him, for he didn't even draw, and made me trade the gallows for the Mexicali blues. Is there anything a man don't stand to lose when he lets a woman hold him in her hands? You just might find yourself out there on horseback in the dark, just riding and riding across the desert sand. Thank you. Oh, we love that song. Thank you so much. I'm gonna switch to the banjo here. Stand by. Didn't mute you that time, buddy.
So while Jackson gets that ready, gets that banjo ready, we'll let y'all know that we do have a EP for sale back there at the merch tent. It's called The June Rise. We just finished it about 2 weeks ago, and we are very proud of it, so we hope you all will check it out and that you will enjoy it as much as we did.
What's up?
Yeah, I don't even remember. Who was the bass player?
Do you know who it is?
Now, there's a lot of folks who contributed to that album in the audience here tonight. Travis Jameson on the bass and Connor Peterson, who played with the Dakota Roots Revival earlier. They were they're highly present on that CD.
Yeah, you know, we're using the CD proceeds to pay Travis Jameson back for all the stuff he did for us. So, I know. I'd like to give a shout out to my friends who I weathered the storm last night with, Dave and Brian. What's up, guys? Kept me warm and dry, thank you. And I never wanted for drink. Here's one off of our that new EP you just talked about. It's kind of a weird one. Moisture management is key to a good set, guys.
This was Frankenstein's theme song when he came to New Mexico. Yeah.
That white-haired guy? Thank you.
Thank you, guys. So I wrote this next song about this young lady I saw on Dr. Phil. She, you know, she wasn't from the streets, but, well, now she wanted to be from the streets. She's on the streets, but she's not from there. And I wondered how she ended up making those choices. And I think Dr. Phil was trying to guide her through it, but it went right over her head. She could just be the Uberman. She might be above all that. You know, cash me outside, girl. Does anyone have a guitar slide we could borrow? A non-sweaty beer can will work just fine. Those things tend to roll. Who's tried to ever tune a dobro before, or a resonator? No, we just retuned this thing. We'll see how it goes. That's a different song.
I got you back, homie.
Guys, we got a couple more songs left. Thanks for sticking with us. Thank you so much.
We can't
wait
to see
the thank you like tomorrow afternoon, okay?
Can't wait to see the rail splitters a little bit later on tonight.
And
honeysuckle. We got two great acts still to come.
Honeysuckle. Suckle. All right, we ready, boys and girls? This is called Dallas. Jazz chord. guys so much, so very much. Checky, checky, oh. Me checky, mucho.
Wanna introduce the last song?
This is just happens to be a song that Keith and I love a lot, and Callie really likes it, and, you know, we love music, and we're always searching for the perfect song. I didn't write this one, but I always thought this was the perfect song. There's a lot of other perfect songs out there, but I sure like it, so we're going to try to do it justice.
This is a song for y'all.
Song for y'all, okay? Like to say thank you to our guitar player who traveled out here, Alex Paul. He just left the stage. He plays mandolin and bass. He's a tremendous songwriter. If you're out in Colorado, you'll see him. He lives up in Telluride, and he's just a great dude. It's great to have you, Alex. Thank you. Keith Warshani on guitar and Resophonic guitar. Give him a hand.
And, of course, the one and only Jackson Magyar.
Thank you.
Captain of the flatboat.
And then we introduced her earlier. Let's do it again. Callie Autry from Nebraska. All right. Doing that thing, boy. Did you leave it out in the storm last night?
Nope, it just came from the desert to the swamp.
It feels like it got rained on. It just got atmosphered on over here.
Strangers on
Thank you so much. See you next year or maybe the year after. Or around the campfire tonight.
All right, here's what we need to do. We're going to find jobs for all these guys up here in South Dakota or nearby in Nebraska, and they're going to move here, and then they'll be closer so that we can enjoy this much more often. Don't you think we can do that? Well, yeah, we can shake the humidity. This is rare. We can shake that. Jackson's parents, we'll find jobs for you guys, too. I promise. All right. A real fun surprise coming up next. But before we do that, I want to tell you a little bit about a couple things. We've been capturing audio for quite a few years and donating it to South Dakota Public Broadcasting, and they've used it for their radio programs. The last 3-4 years, Jeff, these guys have been collecting video, and we've also been donating it. Last year, they chose to use some of the video to make a best of the festival. So how many of you saw that on South Dakota Public Broadcasting? Several of you did. I don't know if they're here, but they didn't do that great a job, honestly. Here was my take. They chose every group, and they kind of chose everything that was just bullet fast. And so they didn't really get the full flavor. So I asked Jeff to create a best of 2017, and he really did. He really did. It's phenomenal. It's 2 hours. And here's the thing. My deal with the musicians has always been this. We will use any of the audio as gifts to public broadcasting. We will use them as gifts to donors and sponsors. But we will never sell any of the collection that we've made. So here's, if you were a legacy donor last year and supported the music in the schools, and it was really fantastic. I think we had about $1,800 donated. It supported the music in the schools programs that operated a session in the fall and again this spring run by Bill Peterson. Bill wants to do that again this coming year, and he's got some really great ideas that I know you'd be impressed with. So, I didn't get this fully organized, but First Dakota National Bank has offered to step in and help us get the right form and the right communication and set up the account so that those donations could be made. And I'm going to make this stipulation. If you donate at least $50 each year as a legacy member, you'll get the opportunity to receive one of these Best of the Festival DVDs. And trust me, it is worth every penny. You will love it. So I've got about 25 made, and I told Jeff I need 25 more already of this past year's. So that's out there. Make a quick visit wherever you need to visit, and we will be back with the surprise. Here's my take on this. Gaynor was so great for all these years. We always counted on him to come up with some group that you went, wow, where'd they come from? Why? How have we not heard of them? This is coming up from Boston. Honeysuckle, that you're in for a treat, so hang in here.
Talking by my true lover's side, and I bet it.